Welcome to this video tutorial. In the following video we will build a sensor panel from scratch. First, we need to enable the sensor panel. And to make it more dynamic, set 1 second update frequency. Since we already know the background image dimensions, it is easier to set it here. Right-click on the sensor panel to open the context menu and launch the sensor panel manager. Select all the default items and click on delete to clear the sensor panel. It is time to add our background image. Now we're going to populate the empty panel with sensor items. Let's add a gauge for CPU utilization. There are several parameters available for each item type. You can position the items by entering the exact coordinates or using the arrow buttons. Our gauge is ready and already working. Now add a graph to display CPU core temperatures. The default graph doesn't fit very well yet, but first we position the top left corner, and then customize its looks. If you want multiple items from the same kind on your panel, it is easier to customize the first one, and then duplicate it. To display all the 4 core temperatures in one graph, we need to duplicate it 3 times and then set each to the appropriate core. To make it even better, let's assign different color to each graph. Let's add some text-based sensor panel items. We have the right position, it is time to customize. The default text is usually too long for a nice design, so let's rename this item. You can add a bar to each sensor item to represent graphically the value associated with it. To make the bar function correctly, you should properly set its value limits. You can move multiple items by selecting them in the sensor panel manager and clicking on the arrow buttons. After selecting a different hardware component, you usually need to readjust the bar limits to make the colors display correctly. You can also edit multiple items by selecting them and clicking on Modify. Let's insert another graph next to our current one. Now it is time to populate the empty space we have left on the panel. So far, so good. Now let's try our panel. We have a nice tool in AIDA64 for this. The system stability test. Let's heat up our computer a bit. First check FPU subtest to drive processor utilization, core temperatures and fan speeds up to their maximum. Now we activate the GPU subtest too, to see how our temperature bar changes. Thanks for watching. You can download the graphics file and the finished sensor panel file from our server. You can find the download link in the description. You can try AIDA64 for 30 days free of charge. It is available for download at www.aida64.com. If you like this tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.